This week, we are looking at the healthcare economy, insurance, pharma, and biotech. We'll start with the insurers, names like Cigna, United Health, Humana. Joining me now is Sarah James. She's Managing Director of Healthcare Services Equity Research at Cantor Fitzgerald. Sarah, thanks so much for going through this with us. So I guess let's start there, and let's talk about United Health. I feel like that's a name that's been coming up a lot on the air on CNBC because of their earnings reports and then because of also a number of our trader contributors that have positions therein. So talk to us about where United sits in this space and how you feel about its prospects going forward.
Sure. So this is an interesting time for the health insurance industry. We're heading into a period where we're seeing costs go up and some real challenges on the rate side. So when I think about United's positioning, they're one of the largest Medicare insurers. That is square in the middle of where the challenges are coming for 2024. So they're well positioned because they're diversified. They're an industry leader. They have a large point of service division as well as technology, but they are going to be exposed to some of the pressure that we're seeing come in 2024.
Okay, got it. And so then what about, you know, if you compare them to, say, a Humana? I understand you're downgrading to neutral, so you also think they obviously subject to pressure as well.
Right. Yeah. So the issue really within the health insurance industry for 24 is seniors put off getting services done during the pandemic. They're starting to come back, and that surprise a lot of the insurers. We're also coupling that with economic challenges. So the government is pushing down on rates and it's crimping margins. So Humana, we recently downgraded because we think they're having the most exposure to that. But when I think about who really works, it's companies that are less exposed to the core insurance and have other ancillary businesses. So two that we like are Elevance and Cigna. Those are both companies that have large exposure to the PBM industry, and for company-specific reasons, we think are poised for some margin expansion as we head into 24, 25, 26. We think that they're a little bit more safely positioned.
Talk to me like a freshman. What is the PBM industry? I don't know it.
Sure. So when you want to get drugs, typically you're going to go to a CVS, Walgreens down the street, or you're going to mail them in. Somebody has to do the back end of that in negotiating drug prices, as well as making sure that you're taking things that aren't counterindicated to what you've already had, and working with the physicians to make sure that you're using the best protocol. So all of that value add is something called a pharmacy benefit manager, PBM.
Oh, and PBM. I thought it was PPM. Mm-hmm. You said. I'm sorry. I do know what a pharmacy benefit manager is. I'm not sure that I like them, but I know what they are.
Yeah, fair enough. There's been a lot of legislation pushes on them, trying to change the way the contracts work. But we actually think we're getting to a point where we're past the majority of the risk. And interestingly enough, as we think about Cigna, they just won a huge $30 billion contract away from CVS. That's the Centene contract. And we think they've got a nice couple-year earnings ramp from that. Elevance, they're the public Blue Cross Blue Shield plan. We're heading into a period of heightened healthcare IT investments where we think the Blues plans are really going to rely on each other for shared services. And Elevance has been signing up a few of them. And we think that's a really unique pathway to top-line growth.
I have a question, Sarah, when it comes to when you're talking about the PBMs, like something like the Mark Cuban's cost plus drugs. I mean, is that sort of a disruptor type of innovation that are trying to lower these costs with or without insurance plans? Is that making any dent at all in some of these bigger players?
Yeah, it's interesting because some of the other insurers are making very similar plans. So I think of CVS. They just launched something very similar where they're going to break out the cost of drugs from the value-added services that they're doing. And it's going to give you that visibility into pricing and spread like the Mark Cuban plan does. So they're definitely taking note and taking actions, but in a way that I think could actually be margin stabilizing for them. Hmm. And at the end of the day, it's about their power to negotiate with the pharmaceutical manufacturers. And I think a key area of that is thinking about GLP-1s. So that's a huge focus for the payers. It could be, if employers added on, it could add 2% of premiums. That's a huge amount for a single drug class. So that certainly is an area where they're focusing on bringing down the price as we're looking at more and more employers adding it on, as well as some state Medicaid agencies requiring it for weight loss.